as West Asia enters a new phase defined by the declared Arab alliances with apartheid Israel. The war on Palestine and its supporters is headed to become even fiercer than before, with the aim of escalating pressure on the Palestinians and forcing them to accept the fait accompli. Perhaps the statements published last week by the U.S. ambassador to apartheid Israel, David Friedman, in which he claimed that the Arab-Israeli conflict had reached the beginning of the end, are clear evidence of this pressure. However, it has slipped the minds and headlines of regional and international mainstream media that the Arab public has yet to declare the end of this conflict, as rejections of normalization echoed throughout the Arab world. Bahrainis took to the streets following the circus of the so-called Abraham Accord, voicing their rejection of normalization with the Zionist entity, their stance with the Palestinian people, and their right to fully recover their rights and land without exception. In Morocco, despite a government ban on large gatherings to prevent the spread of the coronavirus, scores of demonstrators protested outside the Moroccan parliament to denounce Arab countries agreeing to normalize ties with apartheid Israel. Hundreds of Sudanese protesters gathered in the capital Khartoum as well last week to denounce normalization with the Zionist entity, especially after critical reports revealed a secret meeting between the country's military head of state and the Israeli regime's prime minister Benjamin Netanyahu. These are just three examples of thousands of condemnation statements and hundreds of protests across the Arab world and scores of national petitions condemning a U.S. brokered deal to push unsolicited normalizing relations between Arab states and apartheid Israel. Let it be clear, for Trump, Kushner, Netanyahu, and the Arab traitors they signed an empty piece of paper with, it is never over until we, the people of the Arab world, say it is. And we choose Palestine over all of you any day. Welcome to the Middle East Stream. I'm Marwa Osman.